best grapper in this class. It's your time to shine.
Okay, so the 2x minus 2.
Yeah.
And bracket 3, bracket x minus 1. Minus 3x minus 2 squared. Bracket 1. What is it? Divided by x minus 1. Is that that?
I'm gonna pay. Guys, hold on. Okay, guys. I feel like I'm talking to the grade 9 class for some reason right now. Okay. Please. Here's the thing. If you guys need to talk while you're doing your work, and I tell the same story I tell them, that's fine. When I'm up here at the front doing my thing, please have respect. And I know you're sitting with new people today, and that's fine. But have respect when I'm doing my thing, please. Okay. Yes.
Can I go to the next step?
Yeah. Now hold on. I just want to answer Teresa's question here, which nobody heard. So she said, do I need to simplify here? And the answer is, if this was the question, you wouldn't have to. I'm going to simplify it out just for practice here, because I want to make sure you can. So I'm going to do another one with square roots here soon, and those are the ones, remember, you have to take out the 1/2 and all that stuff. So I'm going to do one of those, and you'll have to simplify it. Chris, go ahead.
Wait, okay, because we're only finding the, like, the equation for the tangent and whatnot, we don't really even have to continue.
Okay,
Or should we?
What did I just say?
I'm asking.
He said, well, you don't have to do it, but he's going to do it just because.
Okay, then I'll continue on like that because that's what I did.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so I took out 3x minus 2.
Good.
And then I put in the huge bracket 6x minus 6 minus 3x plus 2, and then all over x minus 1 squared.
Thank you.
I wasn't paying attention, but I was just like making sure.
All right. So I just want to make sure, please, that everyone's feeling okay about this. Okay, I'm going to expand the bracket here and simplify. Are you okay, Calum? Would like the same answer, I hope. Okay. So I'm just going to simplify that into f prime of x equals 3x minus 2. 6x minus 6 minus 3x plus 2 all over x minus 1 squared, which turns into 3x minus 2.
I'm playing here with Kevin Durant.
Kevin Durant.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. So that should be f prime of x. If I pick somebody at random, which is going to be Hannah. What does f prime of x mean in this question? Why do you have to find that? This is your slope, okay? So in order to get your slope, we're just going to sub in f prime of 2. Which is going to be 6 minus 2. All over. Okay, guys, remember what I said? So that's 4 times 2, so m is equal to 8. Hopefully everyone agrees with that. Mostly. Okay, can somebody else tell me how I get my y value? Austin, go.
Plug the 2 into the original.
Original equation. So y is, y is going to be f of 2, which should be 6 minus 2 squared is 16, all right? Over 1, which is 16. To finish up, my equation is just going to be y equals mx plus b. 16 equals 8 times 2 plus b, and wouldn't you believe it, b equals 0. Y equals 8x is your equation. Do you know, I picked that number just out of my head and it worked out beautifully. Normally I try and really focus on them and end up with y equals 6.53x. minus 13.87, like what happened yesterday. Okay, are we feeling sort of good about that? Can I give one with square roots before I move ahead? Then we'll move on to optimization. Here's one with square roots. So this will be example 3.
Yeah, because this is your x, right? No, to get to y, yeah, so the original for this.
What do you mean for?
How is it practical to make the water?
It is.
What's the practicality of all your puns in this whole semester?
They're funny, they make me laugh.
Sure, apparently.
Yeah, water choice, it's amusing.
Okay. Now, what I would do is, guys, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually do this with using quotient rule here. Now, what I will say is on your test, find the derivative of this and simplify fully. So if you do it using logarithms, simplify fully means, you know that ugly looking bracket that you have, it's three things added together, you have to actually add them all together. Okay, so that's what I'm saying, simplify fully. This one's quotient rule is easier if there's something like this. Okay, I will not give you one that's, if there's something with two terms on the top and one on the bottom, you can use logarithms. Okay, but I recommend using quotient rule for these little ones.
Oh, are we doing?
No, I would use both. Please do not, please do not, please do not, please do not. Can I get somebody that's brave and wants to be the first step? Michael Hatcher, go. Yeah.
And then bracket like 2x minus 3.
Yeah. Yeah.
Beautiful. And then 2 times 2 times x plus 1.
Yeah.
Minus 2x minus 3.
Yeah.
1.
Yeah.
Divided by x plus 1 squared.
You know what, Michael Hatcher? You're at 2 out of 4 on that question right now. And it's a good start.
I keep going.
Hold on, you want to keep going? Michael! I'm fully impressed. Keep going.
Okay. So then it's 2x minus 3 negative 1 half.
Okay.
And then they get the bracket 1 times x plus 1.
Yeah.
Minus bracket 2x minus 3.
Now, I'm just going to let the rest of the class catch up to you, Michael, because that's fabulous, if you don't mind me saying in front of everyone here, okay? So what he did, it's sort of rough to get from the first line to the second line. I get rid of a negative one-half always, you'd also get rid of one-halves. Why did Michael not have to go to that one-half like I always do in my work? Yes. It
cancels with the 2.
It cancels the 2 perfectly, so you didn't need to. Okay, right? But if there was a fraction, remember you'd take that out as well, too. Okay, so if you take a look here, negative one-half comes out. Negative one-half changes to a 1, so nothing happens. If you have a positive one-half and you factor a negative one-half, that just goes to the power of 1 there. Yeah.
If 2 wasn't there, what would it be?
So what I do is I take out a one-half, so it'd be one-half 2x minus 3 to the negative one-half.
You just take it if there's like 1 one-half?
Well, then this one would be a 2. We'll do one of those maybe on a different day. Okay, for that? All right, so we're looking good. We're looking great, in fact. Luke, you want to finish this off for me or not yet?
I look amazing.
Wrong. Okay, go ahead.
You gotta bring the negative down.
Okay. Good. What's the other bracket turn into?
Negative x plus 4.
Okay, and for people that are saying, Mr. Sadler, integrals aren't going to be hard. Okay, for Austin that said integrals aren't going to be hard, imagine starting at the bottom and having to work way to the top. That's where calculus gets hard, okay, right? That's where calculus is going to get hard for you guys next year. There are rules and stuff like that that'll show you how to do it, but you can imagine that's where life is going to get tough, okay? All right, I'm going to do one of those on a different day. I'm going to move on to optimization problems. How are we doing for time?
20 minutes.
Okay. Optimization. This is unit 3, sorry. Unit 3 was optimization and graphing.
V? B.
Five.
Sugary. W.
Thanks.
You know, the person on this original desk, if you put her last name somewhere, you become a part. No, that's our team name. Because I had a friend who was like, well, we would call ourselves a part.
Oh, Mr. Sadler, those are all squares.
Starts with an F and ends with a UCK.
Hey, I know you're just kidding around, but please don't kid around in this class.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's a joke.
For a, okay, we will go through lots of these in the upcoming days, because these are the questions that people tend to have problems with. Not these ones, because there's this type of question. There's the one where you have to drill, remember, underwater and then on the land. There's another speed question where you're running and then walking or whatever, right? Or whatever, however it goes. So it says cylindrical can cost 25 centimeters squared on the top, 35.7, you know what I'm saying, centimeters squared on the bottom, and 12 cents per centimeter squared on the sides. For a 100 centimeter cube can, that's 1 liter. If you wonder what that means, that means 1 liter. Minimize the cost. Now I see people pausing, at least one person sitting in the front row. Yes, Alistair. You got it?
Yeah, so you have a surface area equation that incorporates.
Right on. So that's exactly what you're going to need, a surface area. For the surface area of a can.
Are you going to give us the.
Yes. It's going to be top and bottom.
Yeah.
Yes. The sides is going to be. Was it 2 pi RH?
Austin, can you start writing on the test, please?
Okay, so here we go. Those are the equations you're going to need. I'm pretty sure the 2 pi RH is right. The circumference is 2 pi R, right? Of the circumference of a circle times the height. So I think that makes sense for equations, okay?
The circumference.
Because you're still looking for the sides of a can, right? It would be the circumference times the height. Okay, so what you're going to need to do for this is use the volume equation. You're going to need to isolate your H because there's an H in one and an H in the other. And just like what Alistair said, you're going to need to make a surface area equation that's with the cost as well. If you're sitting at the back and you can't see, the top and the bottom are pi r squared. The sides are 2 pi r h. And for the volume, it's pi r squared h. Okay? I'm going to pause in the video. I want you guys to try this out.